whenever we borrow money, to finance the purchase of a car, a boat, furniture, appliances, home repairs, a college education, postgraduate degree, or any other large ticket item. We typically pay more interest to a credit union, bank, or finance company than we earn on our own savings and investments. For example, we might pay interest rates of 6% and 13% on a car loan or credit card, while we earn as little as 1 or 2% on a savings account. We also hope to average 7 or 8% on a 401k account. But there is a way to become our own bankers and profit from our own borrowing and spending. We can set up our own bank and pay interest to ourselves on our own terms, and without any application or loan approval process. It's called private equity banking, and it's made possible by Internal Revenue Code, Section 7702, which allows us to put money into what the IRS refers to as a qualified contract with a legal reserve insurance company. This provision of the tax code allows us to transfer money from our savings or investment accounts, continue earning interest and dividends without any taxation or investment risk. Then, when we need to buy a large ticket item, we can borrow up to 95% of this money, using the contract equity as security or collateral. Of course, there is an internal cost or charge to borrow the money, the same way that banks must pay depositors for the use of their money. This means that we are obligated to pay off these loans with interest, just as we do with a credit union, bank, or finance company. But with our own bank, our collateral continues to earn interest and dividends without any taxation or investment risk. So, our bank equity continues to grow while we use the money any way we want. What's more, there is no application or qualification required, no credit check or reporting to any credit agency, and no delay in getting the money. You simply submit a one-page form and get a check or direct deposit usually within 48 hours. As a revolving line of credit, there is no mandatory repayment schedule. So, we determine the repayment amount, the months or years for payment, and the interest rate we pay back into the contract. And any amount we pay over the minimum is a profit for us, which is added to our bank equity. This is the same way that banks and finance companies profit from lending money. However, before we can borrow any money, we must capitalize on our private equity bank by transferring money into the contract that would otherwise go into our savings and investments. This might include a percentage of our monthly income, a yearly bonus from our employer, an annual tax refund from the government, or any inheritance from relatives, as well as money we've already saved in other accounts. But once our bank is officially capitalized, we can borrow against the contract equity at any time, and as often as we want, without any credit check or loan approval process. We simply submit a short, one-page form to borrow up to 95% of our bank equity. And the money is either sent to us by check or deposited electronically into a checking account within a day or two. What's more, we decide when we want to begin paying off the loan, how much we want to pay, and how often we want to pay it. However, we want to have all our loans paid off by the time we retire, so that we can then supplement our retirement income with tax-free money from our private equity bank. And, if the contract is properly structured, any loan debt remaining at the end of our lives will be contractually paid off for us tax-free. To learn more about setting up your own private equity bank, talk with the financial professional who asked you to watch this video.